Hello everyone, this is MJ with MinIO. In this video, we'll be using the MinIO client and the MC tree command to list prefixes and files in your MinIO environments. The MC tree command lists all prefixes, read prefixes as subdirectories or folders, inside a MinIO bucket in a tree format. The command optionally supports listing all objects inside of a bucket at each prefix, including the bucket root. You can also use the MC tree command against the local file system directory to produce similar results to the tree command line tool that you would use in something like Linux. So here are some examples. The MC tree myminio/mybucket command will show you everything and all of the prefixes at the top level, not the files, but the top level prefixes inside the mybucket. The MC tree myminio/mybucket and myminio/myOtherBucket will list both inside the mybucket and myOtherBucket buckets. MC tree home minio mydata will list the local directories inside minio mydata on your local system. And MC tree --files myminio/mybucket will actually list not only the prefixes or subdirectories, but also all of the files in the myminio alias in the bucket called mybucket. We recommend that you follow along with the MinIO documentation. You can visit these links, which we'll put in the description, for more information, both on the tree command as well as the MC client as a whole. Let's jump into a lab. So here we are in the lab, and you can see that we can run the MC tree command against the local system. In this case, we search the MinIO local directory, and we can see that there are a number of subdirectories listed under there, and they're shown in the tree format so you can understand their relationship to one another. We can also use the MC tree command to look at a remote alias and get the same results back from our MinIO1 alias. The MC tree command also supports using --files switch against remote so that you can see not only the prefixes and their relationship to one another, but the files that are located underneath those prefixes. As with other commands, we can actually list using the tree command from multiple remote aliases. So we can see that we're also calling MinIO2 here as well as MinIO1. The last example we'll give here is that you can choose the depth that you want this to go. So in this case, we'll use MC tree, show the files, but we'll only go to a depth of 1, so it won't search subdirectories when looking at the MinIO1 alias. So this actually only crawls the top level of this, and if you were to specify further down, you could search a single level using the tree command in that case. Hopefully this video helps you get started using the MC tree command. If you'd like to learn more, you can visit us at min.io, or if you'd like to become part of the discussion, please join us at slack.min.io. Thanks and have a good one.